Well, hi there. This is Scott Duffy from getcloudskills.com. And on today's video, we're going to talk about some brand new changes to the DP-900 exam that were just announced today. Now, these changes don't take effect until the end of April, so a month from now. But I wanted to tell you about the changes because they're significant and it might change your opinion in terms of whether you take this exam now or you wait until after April 29th. So first off, there's some changes around the percentages between each of the exam objectives. You can see on screen that on the left are the current four exam objectives and the breakdowns in terms of percentages. On the right are the new four objectives, and you can see the percentages have changed. The core data concepts has gone up from 15 to 20 to 25 to 30, so a 10% increase. The other two objectives, relational data and non-relational data, have actually dropped from 25 to 30 to 20 to 25 and 15 to 20. And finally, the analytics workload hasn't changed in terms of percentage. Now let's look at the individual objectives because some of the changes are quite significant. First of all, the first section, core data concepts, has almost entirely changed. They've removed things such as different chart types, the data analytics techniques, all the concepts around ETL and ELT, and some of these things have been moved until the analytics section. Instead, they've changed the requirements to talk about features of structured, semi-structured, unstructured data, options for data storage, common data workloads, and roles and responsibilities. So these are all new topics for this exam. Although you could argue understanding the difference between structured and semi-structured was covered under other sections. But this first section, again, has gone up by 10% and has totally changed. The second section is relational data. And what they've done is removed a lot of the complex topics. So everything under management tasks for relational databases have been removed. They've also removed any reference to Synapse Analytics, DDL versus DML, so the management query types, PaaS, IaaS, and SaaS differences. What they're doing is focusing on what is relational data, why is it used, what is SQL, and how is that commonly used, and the Azure data services that are related to SQL Server, and then the open source database systems, which are PostgreSQL, MySQL, and MariaDB. So there has been removal of the complex topics and again, a refocusing on the core concepts of relational data. Similar things in terms of non-relational data, they have removed the concept of all the management tasks for non-relational data. Even wording around recommend has been removed. Everything is talking about in the terms of the words describe or identify. And again, lots simpler requirements, and it has dropped by 10% in terms of the significance. And the last section was analytics workloads. And I say the word ironic because the section called analytics workloads was removed, but the core objective is still around analytics, even though the sub-objective was removed. And you'll see on the right, they're focusing on modern data warehouse. They have moved some of the batch and streaming concepts from the first section to here. They removed the visualizations from the first section to here. They've removed the concept of workflow. So a lot of stuff has been removed and just moved down here from other sections. So my take on this is that the exam itself is actually focusing more on truly fundamental topics. So some of the management tasks have been removed. The implementation details have been removed. You do need to understand Azure services, but you don't necessarily need to understand the command line tools that are used to manage these Azure services. I think personally, I think that again, removing advanced topics has been a pretty good idea as well. They've removed things that I think are hard to test. Like even when I was teaching the concept of different chart types, you know, the difference between a bar chart and a pie chart and a line chart, I think I even said in the course, how are they ever going to present a question on this? I couldn't imagine how they would do it. And these things, I think, were on the exam requirements, but were never really ever tested. So they just removed it, even though it was never really tested. So in my opinion, these have all been positive changes. Again, focusing on fundamental data topics and removing some of the more complex topics and removing some of the, I would say, even irrelevant topics. So far, I think this is a good change. Now, I wouldn't even jump to the conclusion that the test is easier. I found this to be quite an easy test already. I don't know if the word easier, it makes sense in this context, but it is focusing on data fundamentals. You can expect more questions around data fundamentals because it's the same number of questions. It's just focusing more on certain topics and removing other topics. So I think this is a purer introductory level data exam. And then you can go on to data engineer or data analyst or database administrator for the higher level questions. Personally, I think this has been a good idea. So much so that if you are planning to take the DP-900 test in April, let's say you have it within the next week or 2 weeks, I might even be tempted to delay taking the test until after the 29th. So take it in May if you're planning to take it in mid-April or late April, because just those types of questions on management tools and some of those more advanced topics have been removed. So I think this can only work in your favor. So focus more on those core fundamental things and less on those other tools and delay taking it until after April 29th. That's my opinion anyways. If you've got it scheduled for tomorrow, you might as well just go take it because you've done all the studying already, I guess. I do have a course on the DP-900. I will be updating the course, of course, on the latest requirements. So as of now, if you go to sjd.ca/DP-900, it'll take you to the Udemy landing page where you can purchase my course for a great price and start the studying. I will have to go soon and modify that course to highlight which of these topics are important after April 29th and which ones you can ignore. I haven't done that yet, but you'll get those updates for free. This is lifetime access, 30-day money-back guarantee. You've got nothing to lose. Take my course, take the test, pass, and that's just another step along your learning journey into the topics of Azure and into the topics of databases. So this has been Scott Duffy for getcloudskills.com. Thank you so much for being here. Please, if you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel as well. I'm trying to increase my subscription count, and so doing that subscription will do me a great favor. So thank you very much in advance for that. I hope you have a wonderful day.